Hello and welcome to the webinar. I will tell you about why we've made the changes and what the changes are. I'll provide you with an update on the support and preparation materials available and then tell you about the plans for the launch campaign. At the end, there will be an opportunity for you to ask your questions. I'm Sally Mattson, one of the assessment services specialists who collaborate with Cambridge English, and I'll be talking you through the whys, the whats, and the whens. I'll then be joined by Lynne Stevenson, the Assessment Group Manager for Young Learners, for a question and answer section, where you will have the opportunity to ask any questions. Let's begin by looking at the revision process timeline. In 2014, we carried out extensive market research with our centres and customers, including teachers, heads of English, parents and learners in key YLE markets. At the same time, we consulted stakeholders, such as professional support leaders and chairs of item writers, and we reviewed feedback from an ALTE audit. In addition, internal experts provided their input on ways the tests could be improved. After informing publishers in September 2015, our focus was on the development and trialling of the assessment criteria for writing and for speaking, as well as developing and trialling our updated results reporting. These activities are now in their final phase. Information about the changes is now available on our website. As well as this webinar, there will be another one in May, which will look more closely at the changes to the question papers. There will also be some suggestions on classroom activities which would be appropriate in the development of the language skills these tasks focus on. There will be local seminars and events running from May, and the new tests will be available from January 2018. So, why have we made the changes? Let's consider first of all what the key strengths are of existing YLE. What do you think is one of the key strengths of the existing YLE tests? Please type your answers into the text chat now. So, can you please type what do you think is one of the key strengths of the existing YLE tests? Just have a look and see what's coming in. Okay, good, so I've got some answers coming through now. Motivation is mentioned quite a few times. All right. That seems to be a good thing. So you've mentioned lots of the reasons why schools and learners love YLE. We've got the colourful and fun activities that motivate learners and reflect sound teaching methodology. The fact there's no pass or fail, so the tests aren't threatening. And every child receives a certificate that rewards their achievement. We've got the importance of testing four skills so that learners develop all the skills they need. The step-by-step progression through the levels, building skills at each level. And the wide range of support materials available. And the research underpinning the tests. So there are lots of great things about the existing tests that we want to keep and that make the tests very popular. So why do we want to make any changes? As part of Cambridge English's ongoing commitment to improving the quality of its tests, all our tests are regularly reviewed to ensure they remain relevant to learners and schools. YLE was last revised in 2007, so we wanted to ensure that it takes into account the latest thinking in curriculum design, pedagogy and assessment for young learners. Another driver for the revision was to position the tests more closely with our main suite exams as part of children's learning journey through school. Lastly, over the past 10 years, the English language learning and assessment market has become more competitive, So we need to ensure that YLE remains the market leader in assessment for young learners. The first stage of the revision process was to find out how users feel about the tests, so we carried out a market research survey in autumn 2014 with centre managers, heads of English, teachers, parents and learners. This showed high levels of satisfaction with all aspects of the tests, as you can see in this slide. The red and blue represent satisfied and very satisfied responses. Green is neither satisfied nor dissatisfied, and purple and turquoise represent dissatisfied. The number of neutral responses to the questions about preparation materials, that's the third and fourth aspects on the slide, may reflect the fact that some people are not aware of what is available, so we will look later on at this area. One of the areas noted where there was potential room for improvement was in results reporting, so we have taken this into account. Respondents told us that they like the fact that there's no pass or fail and that the shields are clear and easy to understand, providing both encouragement and an indication of performance. However, they also wanted more detailed feedback. We'll be looking at the improvements we are planning in results reporting shortly. But first, let's look at the changes to the question papers. Firstly, it's important to note that there are very few changes to the tests themselves. We still have three levels, starters, movers, and flyers. And there are still three components, listening, reading and writing, and speaking at each level. Timing remains the same for all the components. As we've already seen, satisfaction levels with the current tests are very high, and so we were focusing on some very fine tuning during the revision process. I'll now take you through the changes which have been made on the question papers. That will be level by level, and so let's start with starters and the listening test. We have replaced the current part one with a task which is the same as movers and flyers part one, in that people are identified from descriptions and activities. Here's an example of the new task. Instead of placing objects on a picture, children will now identify the people on the scene. The old task focuses on the testing of prepositions, but this is also tested in part four of starters listening. With the new task, we're therefore eliminating repetition, but also showing a steady progression through all three levels, starters, movers, and flyers, by having the same task type present in all, but obviously at the appropriate level for our candidates. Now on to reading and writing. The question paper has not changed to any great extent. We have made some very small changes to two parts, part one and part four. Here's an example of the new part one. We have introduced plural nouns now. You can see that as well as this is a clock, the first question for candidates to respond with a tick or a cross, there is also these are shells. These changes will allow for more variety of language to be used in this part of the test, but in a natural and appropriate way. And here's the new part four. As you can see, it is very similar to the old task, but content will now be semi-factual. This text is all about lizards. The move to a semi-factual task will mean that there is a more transparent content and language integrated learning CLIL element to the test. Now on to starters speaking. Feedback suggested there is very little opportunity for candidates to actually speak in our current test. For example, many of the activities, especially at the beginning of the test, call for non-verbal responses, and as such are testing listening more than speaking. We have therefore increased the opportunity for children to produce spoken language in order to show their skills and shine, while providing support and scaffolding for all candidates. The first opportunity is that the candidate is now asked their name. The second, that parts one and two, which at the moment include a number of non-verbal responses, have been conflated. And the third, an additional question has been included, inviting the candidate to speak more fully about one of the objects in a picture. Here is an example of this "tell me about" question. The speaking examiner will ask the candidate, "Tell me about this box." Support will be provided for any candidates who need it through prompts such as, "What colour is it? Is it blue?" Expected responses are no more than "blue" or "it's blue," which are appropriate for the level. Now on to movers. As far as the listening test is concerned, the first thing I'd like to say is that we've dropped the drawing item from the last part of the listening test. Our research has shown that this task caused anxiety in some candidates due to some being worried that their drawing skills would not be good enough. Feedback also suggested that the drawing task was not age appropriate. We have also replaced the current part 3 with a task which is the same as Flyers part 3. Here's an example. Instead of matching days of the week and activities done on those days, candidates now do a more varied matching task. This one is to match people to the activity they are doing at the moment. The reason for this change was again to show a more steady progression through the levels by having the same task, but obviously at the appropriate level for all our candidates in both the movers and flyers listening tests. Now let's move on to the movers reading and writing. There are a number of changes to the reading and writing test. The task order has changed so that easier tasks are at the beginning of the test. We did a great deal of task performance analysis using tasks from our live tests, and from this we're able to identify and reorder the tasks so that the papers gradually become more challenging, but still at the appropriate level as the children work through the test. The number of questions overall is now 35, down from the current 40. This places movers between starters, which has 25 questions, and the revised flyers, which has 44. The biggest change, however, is that the current part 2 has been removed to allow for the new part 6 extended writing task. Here's a sample of this new task. Supported by a picture, candidates have to first complete two sentences about the picture, then answer two questions, and finally write two additional sentences of their own based on what they can see in the picture. The task has been developed and trialled extensively and provides children with a great deal of support and scaffolding at the beginning before moving to more open-ended responses. The introduction of this task ensures that there is more opportunity for candidates to produce writing at the level appropriate to their ability. Sample tests are now on our website, and so you'll be able to see the format and content of the revised movers reading and writing tests there. Movers speaking has been changed very slightly. Candidates are now asked for their name and age as a natural way to begin the interview. We've also given a written title to the story task and included the name or names of the main characters. Here is an example of the story task. The title of the story, "Fred Loves Food," is clearly in view for the candidates, as is the name of the main character, Fred. We have included this information as our research showed that some candidates worry about remembering the story title and the names of the characters, information given only orally by the speaking examiner in the current tests. This change is therefore to alleviate this anxiety and to provide appropriate scaffolding for this task. Now let's have a look at flyers. And first of all, flyers listening. As in movers, we've dropped the drawing task from part 5, and for the same reasons. Feedback suggested that it causes anxiety in some candidates and was not felt to be age appropriate. The reading and writing test also has similar changes to movers. Task order has been changed so that easier tasks are at the beginning of the test. We've also removed the current part 2 to allow for the new writing task, which is part 7, the final part. Writing skills are now tested more fully. Here's what the writing tasks looks like. Candidates see 3 pictures and write a story about the pictures. This task was developed and then trialled extensively and gives children the opportunity to produce written language through a fun and age-appropriate task. On to the speaking. Candidates are now asked for their name, family name and age as a more natural way to begin the interview. And just as we've done for the movers story task, we now have the title and the names of the characters for the flyers story task. Again, this is to alleviate the anxiety some candidates have in trying to remember these details which they hear from the speaking examiner. Here is an example of the story task. The title of the story, The Brave Teacher, is clearly in view for the candidates, as are the names of the main characters, Nick and Anna. And again, we have included this information as our research showed that some candidates worry about remembering the story title and the names of the characters. This change is therefore to alleviate this anxiety and to provide appropriate scaffolding for this task. Now, onto the changes which concern the word lists. Before we look at these changes, let's have a quick poll. In your opinion, which one of these words has not been added to the starters word list? Please select A, B, C, or D as your guess for the word that has not been added to the starter's word list. So the words are A, enormous, B, fantastic, C, skateboard, and D, tablet. Which one of these words has not been added to the starter's word list? So we'll have a look at some words, some answers that are coming through. Excuse me. I can see a strong preference developing. Okay, so you've given a variety of answers to the poll, with A being the most popular one. Let's look at what the changes are and see if you were right. We have slightly increased the number of words in the word lists at all 3 levels. Using corpus-based methodology, our research indicated a number of words which children were producing naturally at all 3 levels. We did not want to add a great deal of vocabulary and wanted to stay within a 10% maximum increase at each level, which we have. Some examples of the new words are at starters, tablet, an example of a new word which has great currency. Fantastic, a word which we saw from the research was part of candidate vocabulary at this level, and skateboard, to make a natural addition to the lexical set of sporting activities. At movers, we have added e-book, another example of a new word, and ill, and film star, as additions to lexical sets. At flyers, by myself, enormous, and earth, as in the planet, are examples of some of the words now in the word list. We have also moved some words from movers to starters and from flyers to movers. So, did you guess correctly in the poll? The answer is A, enormous, which is new to the flyers word list and not starters. The updated word lists are also now on our website. Let's now move on to some of the bigger changes to the tests. The new writing scales to assess the new writing tasks, the new speaking scales, and the changes we will be making to our results reporting. So, alongside the new writing tasks, one for movers and one for flyers, we needed to make mark schemes for these tasks. The statements you can see are the most basic CEFR can-do descriptors that we were aiming for with these tasks. And the one you can see for movers, that they can write short, simple phrases about everyday topics or concrete situations, is exactly what this task asks them to do. For flyers, we're aiming for the candidates to show that they can write a short message. In this case, they're not asked to write a postcard or an email, but they're asked to write a story about the pictures. The assessment scales have been developed and trialled several times, and the key piece of information here is that the marking criteria are designed to focus on communicative success and clarity. We're really encouraging the learners to focus on what they're able to communicate, which is an appropriate goal for this level. We often get questions asking about accuracy of grammar and spelling for these tasks. The answer to this is that we are looking for responses which are comprehensible. This is accurate enough at these very low levels, A1 and A2. Apart from this being important for the level of writing skills being tested, the tasks have also been designed to support teachers in teaching extended writing skills, and so the mark schemes are meant to facilitate that too by focusing on communicative success. Also, for the benefit of teachers and schools, we're going to be publishing guidance on the marking criteria so that teachers are informed about what they're aiming for on these two new writing tasks, and they're able to fully prepare their students for the completion of these tasks. Now, onto the speaking assessment changes. Although the last revision of these tests was in 2007, the scales have been in use since 1997 and have never been explicitly aligned with the CEFR or the main suite exams, that's key, preliminary and so on. They are also currently on a 0 to 3 scale, and speaking examiners have repeatedly asked for a broader scale to enable them to diagnose candidates' performance in more detail. And so the new scales are for each level, starters, movers and flyers, and they're on a 0 to 5 scale, which brings them more in line with main suite speaking tests and also answers the request from examiners to allow them to be more precise about the skills that candidates are showing in their speaking. What you're seeing on this slide are the criteria that have been developed for this revision. The criteria are similar for all three levels, but movers and flyers have some criteria which are not used for starters. These are shown in italics on the slide. You'll see that starters has vocabulary, but for movers and flyers, there is vocabulary and grammar. Cohesion isn't included for starters. That's because candidates at this level just produce single words or a couple of words at a time. Pronunciation has individual sounds and word stress for starters, but the addition of stress in general for movers and flyers. Because at the higher levels, children are beginning to produce more extended speech. And intonation is not relevant at starters, but it is for movers and flyers, again because of more extended speech at these levels. Finally, interaction is used at all three levels. That's the ability to understand and respond, the amount of support needed from the examiner to do the task, and then fluency and promptness in responding. The current speaking scales are not public, but these new scales will be, again responding to feedback from teachers and also to show very clearly how their students will be assessed. Now let's move to results reporting. First of all, the certificates are remaining the same. Key stakeholders were clear about how much they value the status of the certificate, and so these are remaining as tangible examples of candidates' achievement. There is no pass or fail, and the focus will be on each candidate's achievement. We are adding some information to the back of the certificate. You can see this on the right-hand side. There are two parts. The first is the diagram at the top, which shows how shields at starters, movers and flyers line up, and then also how flyers and key for schools match up too. How all these tests match up on the CFR is also shown. This was another major piece of work that we did on this revision. Below this table, you can see the can-do statements for each of the levels, and that's to help interpret what it means to be at each of these levels and to provide support, especially for those who may not be familiar with the CEFR. We're also developing a new statement of results, and work on this is ongoing. This will be quite an important addition to the reporting that really feeds into the learning ethos of YLE. We're also responding to requests for more detailed feedback. The statements of results in development are designed to meet these needs, and specifically to provide helpful information for the classroom and for families on what students can do and what they're still grappling with. As I said, work is ongoing, and we will have more information about the details of what exactly the statement of results will include and when they will be introduced later in the year. The plan, however, as you can see in the draft version shown here, is that young learners will receive some information on their strengths, will receive some information on things that they can work on to improve further, and they will also receive some ideas for things that they can do in order to improve. The reverse of the statement of results is exactly the same as the reverse of the certificates. And so, to quickly summarise the changes, there are very few changes to the question papers. Stakeholders from the candidates to their teachers and school heads will not get any big surprises. There is a new listening task in both starters and movers to show a more steady progression through the levels by having the same task, but obviously at the appropriate level for all our candidates. Writing tasks have been introduced at movers and flyers to give children the opportunity to produce written language through fun and age-appropriate tasks. Children will also have the opportunity to produce more language during the speaking tests, although we're always with support and scaffolding. We have also introduced some changes to ensure that YL tests are positive experiences for our candidates. Aspects of the current tests, such as the drawing tests, tasks in movers and flyers listening and the storytelling tasks in movers and flyers speaking have either been removed or have added supports provided in order to eliminate some of the anxiety that we've discovered some candidates experience. And we have reordered the tasks in the movers and flyers reading and writing tests to ensure that the easiest tasks start the test. New mark schemes have been developed and trialled extensively to ensure that the new writing tasks are able to be assessed in a reliable and robust manner. The current speaking assessment scales have been updated to allow speaking examiners to more finely tune their assessment of our candidates. And finally, we're developing a new statement of results. This is an important addition to the reporting, one that really feeds into the learning ethos of YLE. And we've done this because we consistently get requests for more information on candidates' English skills, so these statements of results are designed to meet these needs. More information on these will be available later in the year. So, let's now look at support and preparation materials. It's important that the learners feel confident when taking the exam, so we are updating our support materials to help them prepare well. Before we look at the updates to support materials, which of the existing support materials for YLE do you find most useful? Please type your answers in the chat box. So that's which of the existing support materials for YLE do you find most useful? You put your answers in the chat box now and we'll have a look at them. Okay, so some are coming through now. I can see sample tests, handbooks, posters. Okay, so of course, many of you have written sample tests and we'll be providing new sample tests during the course of this year, with the first one for each level already available on the Cambridge English website. Updated versions of the word lists and the handbook for teachers in electronic format are also available on the website. By April, we will provide updated versions of the brief exam guide and information for parents and teachers. The word list picture books are also being updated to take into account the changes to the word lists. Also by April, we plan to update the classroom posters, the classroom activities that go with them, and the progress charts that show how well the child is progressing with the activities. And we will update the lesson plans that are available in the teaching resources area of the Cambridge English website to reflect the changes to the tasks. Updated speaking test videos will be available in August, both for training speaking examiners and to give teachers and learners an example of what the revised speaking tests are like. In the case of the games and online activities that are available, we are not revising these, as these are mainly aimed at practicing vocabulary and grammar that is still relevant to the revised tests. These include games for PCs and mobile devices, such as Monkey Puzzles, Shop and Drop and Funland, our very popular Sing and Learn videos, and the short interactive learning activities that are available on our website. Just to finish, what are the key benefits of the revised tests in addition to the existing benefits we discussed at the start? Can you spot which one of these statements about the benefits of the revised tests is false? Please select A, B, C, D or E for the one that is not true. So can you write this in the poll part of your screen? So just in case you can't see, we've got A, progression between YLE levels and onto Key for Schools is even clearer. B is the tasks reviewed to ensure they're age appropriate and don't cause anxiety. C is improved alignment to CEFR, giving an even clearer view of a learner's level. D is candidates won't get shields, just feedback on how to improve. And E is writing and speaking marking criteria published so teachers are more confident of students' readiness for the test. So we'll have a look at the results. And yes, well done. So pretty much all of you have spotted that D is false. Candidates will still get shields for each skill, but also more feedback on their strengths, weaknesses and how to improve. I hope this session has been helpful, and we do have some time to answer any further questions you might have. I'm going to hand over to Nancy now, who will talk to you about further support for teachers. Please type in your questions now, and we'll do our best to answer as many as we can.
Thank you very much, Sally. That was a really interesting webinar. This is Nancy again, and I'm just on audio, so you can't see me. While I'm talking, Sally and Lynne are going to look through the questions that you've already sent in. And we've got a few ready for them to have a look at. But if you have still got a question that you haven't already sent in, if you could type it in the chat box now, and then there's a chance that we'll be able to answer it for you. And let me just remind you as well that you'll get an email after the webinar, probably towards the end of the week, which will contain a link to the recording. Quite a few of you have been asking during the webinar, so can we see it again or can we get the slides, etc. You will get a link to the recording, so you'll get the whole lot. You'll be able to see the slides, listen to the presentation all over again in your own time, if you want to do that. So don't worry if you've missed a little bit. In that email, you'll also get a feedback form and you'll get a certificate of attendance. Okay. Now, I'm going to talk about some of the official preparation materials for the revised Young Learner exams, which we hope that you'll find useful. So the first thing is Kids Box, and this is a 7-level general English course. So there are 7 different books for 7 different levels. This is an updated second edition of this set of books, and it now includes official preparation for the Cambridge English Young Learners, and that's been validated by the Cambridge English Exam Assessment Team. And these books, they also have many features that you'd expect from a general English course, things like CLIL projects, phonics, and online practice as well. And the next resource we've got is Fun for Starters, Movers and Flyers. And this is the 4th edition of these books. They've just been updated and they work really well alongside a general English course. And they include online activities for students. And there's also a vocabulary app, which is quite good fun as well. And the next resource we've got is Story Fun. And this is the 2nd edition of these books. There are 6 levels, and that's 2 for each of the tests. So there are 2 books for each test. And each level contains 8 different stories, and the stories form the basis for learning English. The books also have integrated skills practice, and that includes speaking, and that prepares students for the test tasks. And there's also a home fun booklet for each level, and that helps to bridge the gap between home and school. And it also encourages parents to get involved in their child's learning. Next, we've got a set of practice tests. There'll be 3 sets of full colour practice tests for the revised exams so that the young learners know what to expect on the day. And the next thing we've got is a website for young learners tests, and it's called World of Fun. And this contains information, resources such as videos and teaching tips and lots more as well. You can also look on this website to find out more about the materials that I've just mentioned now. And we do realise that for those of you who are using materials for the current exams, you might not be able to adopt the new materials immediately. So from transferring from older materials, what we would recommend is that you start supplementing your current materials with the resources that we've just mentioned. So for example, you could start using the new sample tests. You could start bringing in the new word lists and picture books. There's the speaking test videos and, of course, the World of Fun website resources. So you could just gradually start integrating the new resources with the resources that you're currently using. And don't forget, the new practice test books will also be helpful, even if your core materials aren't changing. And then the final resource I've got for you is the Teaching English website, and this is on the Cambridge English website. You can find on this site, you can find free resources for teachers. You can get information about teaching qualifications, and you can get information about the Cambridge English Teaching Framework and more webinars as well. And also, if you want to sign up for a newsletter on that site, you can do so and you'll get updates and articles. Okay, well, that's it from me. I'm now going to hand you back to Sally and Lynne, who will answer some of your questions from this webinar on the revised young learners tests. Thank you.
Hello again. I've now been joined by Lynne Stevenson, who is the Assessment Group Manager for Young Learners. Here are some questions that were sent in during the webinar. So, Lynne, could you take the first one?
Okay, if I could just deal with a couple of practical ones. A lot of you were asking, when do the new tests become live? And any students who will be sitting these tests from the 1st of January 2018 will be sitting the new tests. So up to December 2017, we've got the current ones, and then as soon as New Year's Eve over and done with, we're into the new tests. Okay, the other, a couple of people were asking about the new speaking tests and the format of the speaking exams. And one person was asking, is the child still accompanied into the speaking test room by an usher? And yes, that will still be the case. We really feel that this is an important part in ensuring that it's a very non-threatening and friendly environment for young children to go through an English test. And so the usher is certainly part of that, even though the child will be asked their name when they're sitting down and the test has begun. Okay, some other questions about the speaking tests. The full script from the speaking examiners is in the practice tests. So if any of you want to have a look at the full script there or an idea of exactly what the child will be asked, that will be the place to look. But there are a lot of details and practice material on the Cambridge English website for this. And the important thing for the speaking, we really feel, is that the child feels comfortable and is ready to do the speaking test at that level. So that would be a lot of classroom practice, confidence, lots of games building up vocabulary in order to build a child's confidence, so that what we really want the child to do is to go into that speaking test room and show us what they can do and really shine. So confidence is a lot of that, plays a big part in that.
And some mm-hmm. people are asking if the materials mm-hmm. are already available. And right. they are, aren't they?
Yes. Yeah, there are one set of sample tests for each level on the Cambridge English website. The updated word lists are already on our website. And there are also handbooks for the teachers, the electronic version, on the website. That's going to be supplemented going forward with information about how the writing tasks for the new writing tasks for movers and flyers are being assessed, and we will be providing sample scripts and commentaries and advice in the teacher's handbook for preparing your students for these new writing tasks. And we'll also be publishing the speaking scales, so that as teachers you'll know exactly what how your students are being assessed in this part of the test as well.
Yeah, so there's plenty mm-hmm. of information
yes,
out there already.
There will be, yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. would you like to take another question?
Okay, a few questions coming in about ages for young learners. More or less we're talking these tests are suitable for primary school children and perhaps children in the first years of secondary school or junior high or schooler media that year. So it's roughly 7 to 12 year olds. But of course, you know, some children, younger children, could be ready. And for some older children, flyers would be totally appropriate for them as well. Okay. And then, right, so, yeah, just to stress, the tests will be live from January 2018. We've got the age limits. The sample tests, as we said, are available now. So, a couple of people asking where they can find the books that Nancy was talking about. If you go to your local ELT bookshop or look online for CUP, you'll be able to find the materials there. Or if you go into Cambridge English website and have a look at our teachers' resources there for young learners, you'll be able to find plenty of materials on that.
Someone's asking why we can't have the sample speaking tests before August, but that will take quite a long time.
That's right. The filming and all the commentaries are going on nearly as we speak at the moment for that, and then as soon as they're all complete, they will be available for you.
And that's still plenty of time before the tests go live, isn't
yes.
it? They're not happening until January.
That's
2018.
Right. Yeah, so there will be the whole of the period from September right through to January in order to prepare your students for those. Okay, and a lot about practice.
Some people are asking about what the criteria will be for evaluating the writing. We're going to have more information about that later,
yes.
aren't we?
As I was saying, and we will be providing sample responses to these writing tests with commentary, you know, at different levels, with commentaries of how they are marked. So you'll have a very good indication of the testing focus for those.
Okay. Oh, somebody's asked if speaking examiners will need more training since the assessment criteria are being revised. And
yes.
they will, won't they? Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
That's right. Certainly experienced young learner speaking examiners, as we've seen from Sally's explanation of the changes to the speaking test, the speaking test materials, are going to be very similar. The examiner script is going to be incredibly similar. So very few changes actually in the exam room, but there will be the use of the new assessment scales. And so all young learner speaking examiners will have to do training on the actual use of the assessment scales.
So, some questions here I think have already been answered by Nancy about materials.
Yes, and as we were saying, there are already quite a lot of resources on the Cambridge English website as well for this. Somebody is asking, is the audio online as well? Yes, if you go into the sample tests that are there is an audio with that you'll be able to listen to as you're going through the question paper. So it's a complete listening test, which is on our website at the moment.
Someone asked, have any of the timings been changed? And we've already said that they're not changed, haven't we?
So that's right. All the timings remain the same. So it will be the same for listening, for reading and writing, and for speaking. There's going to be no difference in test timings.
And someone says, can an 8-year-old do the flyers test?
I think that probably depends on the 8-year-old.
If they're ready.
certainly if they're ready and feel confident and comfortable with that, then why not? And we've got a similar question. If an older child can sit movers, there is no age limit for these tests. If you feel that the test is appropriate for your students, then please do that. The important thing is that it's a very positive and a stressless start to a kind of English learning journey for these young learners.
And someone asked, how do you choose between a child taking flyers or Key for Schools? And that would again depend, wouldn't it?
Right. Again, the young learners tests are achievement tests. They're high facility, they're fun, they're friendly, very child friendly. Key for Schools have just moved up a little notch for that. So again, that would depend on the child. Probably worthwhile having a look doing sample tests for flyers, sample tests for Key for Schools, and then going from there, you know.
And again, there are plenty of resources available online, so
that's right.
The teachers can check.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. I can't see any more new ones.
Okay. I think
we've got some questions about teaching, but I think we've got lots of answers on the Cambridge English website about that, so we probably won't go into classroom. We're going to have some more information about classroom activities in the next webinar.
That's right, yes. That will be focusing very much on the changes we've made to the question papers and how children can be prepared to cope with those. And a couple of you have asked about the methodology, our approach to testing of very young learners. We're just about coming to the end of this seminar at the moment, but could I say we will be publishing a report into the whole of our revision process, which will explain that and the research that we have done in order to ensure that what we have got are high achievement, fun assessments, which are suitable for this age group.
Okay. So, there we are. I think that's all we have time for. So, thank you for attending this webinar. I hope you found it useful. The next webinar coming up is on Understanding Listening Assessment, What Every Teacher Should Know. Goodbye.
Goodbye.